Hi, welcome to this quick video to demonstrate the design of a simple structural element such as the RC slab. These are the details of the slab that we will be designing. So it's going to be a 6 by 7.2 meter slab. The dead load is 6 kPa, live load is 5 kPa. It will be supported on all four sides by RC beams. And we'll be designing using Eurocoat, and here are the concrete grades and the steel rebar strength that will be used. We use Tekla Structural Designer for this RC slab design. First thing you do is check the settings and use the template that is suitable for your project or for your locale. So here I'm using the Singapore settings, but you can actually import the suitable one for yourself or for your project. And it will set things like languages, views, reports, units, and more importantly, the design codes. So these codes, you can still change it. So if you're using British code, Euro code, you know, or US code, all these can be redefined within this setting. And once you have the setting, you can save it as your company settings as well, or as a template for everyone to use. Also, we have design settings to tell the software how would you like to detail your rebars in the RC structures. So all these can be defined. So today we're going to talk about the slab, right? So the options here for slab design, flat slab and slab on beams, and then the minimum rebar and the spacing. All right, all these can be set by the user. Other things such as, you know, analysis settings. Okay, all these are by default, so if you're not sure what these are, then don't touch it. If you know what you're doing, you can change the modification factors to suit the outcome that you're expecting for your structure. All right, and then we have a drawing tab, because the software also produces 2D layouts, right? General arrangement drawings as well as detailed design drawings. So for example, scales of each of the different plans and details set up here, and you can change them as you go along and during the design as well. So things like line type, layering, font size, all these can be customized to suit your company standards, right? There are a lot more that you can define here, but that's what we're going to look at today. So I'm going to click OK and start opening a new project. Okay, so then you see that the top ribbon more buttons gets turned on. That means these are active now and you can make use of them. And I like to split my views into 2D and 3D views. So what's important to note is that whichever view you click on, that's the active view. Okay, so this is important because when you start assigning or creating your inputs, right? These active views will determine what type of input you can use, right? So we're not doing BIM integration today, but if you are, you can make use of the BIM integration to save time on modeling. So today I just want to create my outline of my slab, so I can use grids to do so. So I'm going to start with that, and then I'm going to show you how to do it using the standard coordinates. So you can set your origin. All right, and then basically set the size of your slab. So it's a 7.2 length and width is 6 meter slab. All right, and if you want to rotate it, you can. Otherwise, you can click next and then create an orthogonal slab here. Okay, so this is the 2D and 3D view. Now, at the side here, the other way to create your slab, you can, traditional method, use the points. So I'm going to set this away from the grids. 10 meters is my point 1, and then I'm going to set point 2, 6 meter width, and then the length of my slab. So to create the points, so now I have 4 points, right? You can see that here as well. Alright, so the next thing we can do is if you follow the tab at the top here, I'm in the modeling mode, so I can start inserting my support. Alright, so you have 6 degrees of freedom, so I just need some pin support. So I'm just going to create my pin support by releasing my MX and MY, and then start inserting the support at the nodes or intersections of the grids. Okay, so you can see them. You can also toggle between 2D and 3D in your level view. Alright, so this is my active view right now. And I can continue here by inserting the supporting beams. Okay, the properties of the beams can be selected and modified at the property pane over here. So we can modify accordingly and then click to insert, double click to end. Okay, so I also want to assign the beams to the other side at the node, so you can window everything and then hit the copy button. And then you have a selection what you can copy. So I just want to copy the concrete beams, right? So you can do so. And then what you do is once this is selected, you can pick a reference point and then paste. So it's a copy and paste function that's very useful. All right. So now I have two sets, right? I have the grids and then I have the nodes. But basically, I'm modeling the same thing. So the next step is to insert my slabs. All right, so the area that turned green means you can assign slab in those areas. All right, but first make sure that it's a two-way slab. And the thickness that I want to use is 200, and this is the concrete grade. And then I'm ready to insert. All right, so now I have my slab, right? So the next thing I want to do is, if you follow the tab from left to right, is to go to the loading tab and then to set up my load cases. So they're already set up for you, some of them dead and live. So if you don't need anything, you can delete it. If you want to change the name of your load case, you can. So I'm going to change it to slab bit and slab imposed, SE and SI. Alright, so once you set that up, you can see at the bottom bar, they are available for your selection. So to insert the dead load of this slab, I'm going to select SD and then I'm going to use either the level button or the slab load button or the area load button. So because we're talking about slab, I'm just going to use the slab load button and then I'm going to specify my dead load as 6 kPa. All right, and then click on the slab and then it's assigned. All right, you can actually see the assigned value. If you press escape, you can hover over the load and you can see that 6 kPa has been applied. Alright, so I'm going to do the same for the imposed load, but imposed load is 5 kPa, so I'm just going to put 5 and then assign. Escape out, and then you'll see the slab load or the slab imposed. So then what you want to do is to create your load combination. So there's an auto generate button. All right. So if you have very complex, you have wind, you have seismic, that's a very useful thing. But right now I'm going to use it just to create my gravity load. So because I choose Eurocode, right, these are the factors that's been used, but you can actually change it if you want to. All right. EHF is the automated and required equivalent horizontal force to be applied to any structure. So you can tick this. If you don't tick it, then it won't be created. But if you tick it, you can see it here. Now, the reason is that you can actually turn on and turn off any load combinations during your analysis and design. So I'm just going to keep the gravity load combination on for this particular demonstration. All right, so now I'm ready for the next step, which is to analyze. So if you hit the analysis button, okay, you can actually see what's going on here. So the analysis takes about less than 1 second and it's actually all done. Okay, so all these analysis has been performed. And when you review it, you can see now that the decomposed load has been assigned to the beams. All right, so for those of you who are curious, what's the loading on the beam, you can click on the beam, right click, and then you can open up a load analysis view for that particular beam. And the loading can then be seen. So this red bar here, all right, allows you to see the force, the loading and the moment and the forces on that particular beam. Okay, so that's just a sidetrack there. Now, to view the analysis results of the slab, all right, so I'm just going to change this a little bit, enlarge it, and then I'm going to put it back into a 2D view. And what you can do is to view the results of your analysis is to basically turn on the finite element analysis, all right, and then you can check out the results in terms of moment at the top, moment at the bottom, X and Y direction. Okay, so if you're doing a base slab, then there's bearing pressure contours that you can see and other stresses if you're interested. Okay, the other thing you can see are the deflection contours as well. Okay, and also the area required. Again, you have the X, Y, top, bottom arrangement that you can view. All right, now the other thing that might interest you, if let's say you have an irregular slab or you have slab with openings, okay, then the tab here allows you to create strips across anywhere on the floor. Okay, so to do so, just hit the result strip. All right, make sure that the result strips view is turned on using your scene content. All right, now then you can click anywhere, okay, to create a cut across the slab. All right, so that you can view the result. So for example, right now, it's showing deflection. So let me turn this off, all right, and then turn this into a 3D view. And then make sure that my mode combination is turned on. And then I can actually see the deflected shape along that strip. Okay, and then the forces. Alright, so you can see all this information within the strip if that's what you're interested in. It's very handy for irregular slab or even regular slab. Okay, so this is some information that you can get out of the software. Now, the next thing that I want to do is to look at the design of the slab. Okay, so I'm just going to switch this back into 2D and then turn it back to my structural view. And then I hit the design button. Okay, so it's done the design. However, you can see that it's done the design because when you right click on the panel, you can check the design information. Okay, so over here, the rebar has been assigned. Okay, so you can see the summary over here and the utilization ratio, area provided, area required. And however, what happens is that the span depth ratio has exceeded the code limit. All right, so we have to change something. So I'm just going to keep it simple. Usually we can't change the loading. So what we'll do is we will change the slab depth. So I'm going to increase it by 20 mm. Okay, so once you change the slab depth, the analysis is no longer valid, so what you need to do is reanalyze it. And don't worry about the self-weight of the slab because it's automatically calculated and assigned to the structure. So now I can hit design again after the analysis. And you can see now that the slab has turned green. Okay, and if you check again the panel, you can now see that the span depth ratio is passed. So that's how you can tweak and make sure that your design is code compliant. All right. So the next thing is you might want to create your own report. Okay. So there are already some default reports that you can make use of, but otherwise you can create your own. So I'm just going to create a report for slab. Okay. And over here, you can drag and drop any of these information into your calculation. So I just want to create a panel report, and what you can do is you can specify what level of details you want in your report. So for example, you want a summary or you want a full detail. Alright, so once you have that, you can select that report and show it. Okay, enlarge it. So this is the report that you see, the same information you have in the check panel view. Okay, so these are all done automatically. And you can then publish it in PDF or send it out to Word, Excel, tests to compile with other calculations. All right, so the other thing you'll be interested to see is that after the design, okay, when you view the SLAB rebar, okay, you can then see the bottom bar in the X direction, okay, as well as the Y direction, it's the same, and the top bars in the X and the Y direction, okay. You can also use mesh if you want to, okay. So you can then create mesh instead of straight rebars. All right. So the next thing I want to do is actually to show you the same information but in the drawing mode. Okay. So you can actually create drawings, and in this case, I just want to create the slab details drawings. So these are the settings. You can change them if you want to. Okay, so this is my drawing in AutoCAD view. All right, so if you have other CAD system, it will open in whatever CAD system that you're using. So what you can see is the rebar bottom, rebar top, all right, and the slab thickness. And you can also see the tabulated rebar quantities, all right, including a 10% detailing allowance. Okay, so these are available if you would like to create the drawings. All right, so obviously you can also create plans, key plans, okay, use the general arrangement tab to create those. But otherwise, you have all the information within one software. You have the design report as well as all the drawings. The other report that might interest you would be the material list. Okay, so this is actually the same quantity that you see on the drawing, except that it includes all the concrete volume, including the beams. All right, so that concludes my demonstration for this particular video.